Hi guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. In this video, I will be sharing with you how you can save at least 50% on your monthly subscription for your favorite cold email platform. Now, if you think about it, most of these cold email platforms are charging you for the number of active contacts you have in there. But that pricing doesn't make sense to me anymore. For example, Instantly charges like $30-$40 for 1,000 contacts, and Smartly charges around the same as well. So there is a platform called ManyReach which will not ever charge you for the number of active contacts you have in there. So there is no monthly fee you are paying. You can upload unlimited contacts. I discovered this and I was really amused about it, right? So they will only charge you for the number of emails you are sending. So it's basically like a recharge. You buy certain credits, you send emails, and you only need to pay more when you are sending more emails. So it's only pay as you go. And with this, you can upload unlimited contacts as well. So it makes targeting your TAM very easier. It has an inbuilt CRM as well, so you can manage your list better. So you don't really have to keep deleting your leads every other week from Smart Lead or Instantly to make space for more campaigns. You just can start new campaign and only pay when you are sending emails. Now in this video, I will be going over how cold email platforms really work and what really gets you results. I will also be showing you how you can set up a campaign inside ManyReach, and I'll be sharing the results that we are getting as well. So let me just jump over to my screen and show you around. Now if you're a lead gen agency owner or anyone who sends more than 10,000 emails a month, do not miss this, because I'm gonna save you so much money right now. And if you manage multiple clients, this will totally change how you manage your agency. It's similar to most the platform that you use, right? But I would say it better in terms of it lets you white label the platform, and you can also easily create how many workspaces ever you want. So if you want to give access to any client, you don't have to pay anymore for that. I was paying $30 for every user to Smartly. I'm not gonna do that ever again. The most important thing with any outreach platform right now is how good their warm-up process and warm-up pool is. While warming up my 80 email accounts, I have seen they have paid really good attention to how my email accounts are doing and made sure that only the email accounts that are best fit is in the warm-up poll. So they are not tolerating any emails that won't help you increase your credibility with Google. That's the number one thing while selecting your cold email platform. Second, what process do they have to send the emails? And I think that's all. While you have to decide on quality of the cold email platform that you are using, everything other than is really secondary, because if they are not solving these two things, then it doesn't matter even if the platform is free. So I wouldn't have ever used if they haven't solved these two major issues. Pricing is the biggest payoff here. You're not paying monthly fee. And next, I'm gonna be comparing the pricing for you, and then I'll show you how to use it as well. Now I'll show you how the credit work. Let's say you buy 100,000 credits for them. So there is one credit for each email you send, but they will also charge you for the warm-up. But for warm-up, you're paying only 0.1 credit. So let's say for each email account, if you are sending 20 warm-up emails per day, that's 2 credits. And if you're sending 20 cold emails, so that's 22 credits per day per email inbox. So if you're using 100 inboxes every day to send 50 to 60,000 emails, you are only spending 60 to 65,000 credits, and that's not even $100. I'll show you the pricing comparison. So if you check out the Instantly pricing, they will charge you $37 for 1,000 uploaded contacts. You are not going to do more than one campaign with this pricing, and even with $97 plans, you will struggle. If you have more than 3-4 clients, you will keep deleting the list and everything, right? It doesn't make any sense, and you have to pay for the CRM on top of that. Let's talk about Smartly. It's $94 plan. You are getting 30,000 credits, still fine, but if you want to give access to a client, you are being charged $30 per month without any additional credits. That doesn't make any sense to me. Talking about $94 plan, you can send only 100,000 emails in a month. First of all, this doesn't make any sense to me, because then you can't really achieve that in 30,000 active leads, because we will be sending only 2 emails per lead. But if you see the pricing for ManyReach, you can get 100,000 credits for $99, which is the plan I would consider you go for. So let's assume, and we want to reach out to 20,000 leads per month. That's two email per account. So to do that, in each of these we have to pay $94-$95. But with ManyReach, if we reach out to 20,000 new prospects every month with two emails being sent out, you would only spend 42,000 credits for that, and it will last almost 2.5 months. You are not paying monthly fee, and on top of that you have unlimited sending accounts. You can create unlimited workspaces, which is the biggest positive here. You have 10 clients, create 10 workspaces, give them access. No need to worry about sending reports every month, every week. They can access the platform, they can see what results they are getting. And even if you want to try it out, just try for 10,000 credits, try it for one campaign. I can guarantee it will perform better than other, because I'm gonna show you the results right now that I'm getting. Also, other than the platform, they have built a really cool Facebook community as well, which I will also attach the link below, and you can join in and connect with other users. I know in the space we are always looking out for someone to relate to our problems, and it's really hard to find people who are going through the same thing. So having a real community really helps mentally and technically as well. And if you're someone who is already using hundreds of accounts, I would say just try it for 15 to 20 email accounts of yours. Even if you try with 10,000 credits, you will know how much better it is. And you get all these features with all the plans. It's just about how many credits you are buying. And now let me show you the results you are getting, and then I'll show you the process of setting up an email campaign. Now, before moving on to ManyReach and disconnecting all my accounts from Smart Lead, I was running a campaign last month. Now, when I decided to test out ManyReach for my company, I was running Smart Lead. We started a campaign for 31st March and we had great expectations from it. We knew the scripts were perfect. We had the accounts been warming up for a while, but the results we got were not really aligning with our expectations. Getting two positive replies from 3000 plus leads is not what we are here for. We want to get 30 positive replies from 3000 leads. We usually get 3-4% reply rate and even more positive replies. So we were really concerned what's wrong. And that's when I decided to switch to ManyReach, and this was one of the recent campaigns that we did. So basically what we did was we disconnected or switched off warm up for all of our accounts on Smart Lead, connected the same accounts in ManyReach, warmed up them for 1 week, obviously slow warm up until we are about like 30-40 emails per day on each account. And then I started this campaign around like last week only, right? And we started slowly as well, and then we really switched on the volume. From 483 emails we sent, we got 16 replies, and 3-4% reply rate is really good without even a lot of follow-ups. And because I know when we do more follow-ups, we're gonna get much better reply rate. So this is what really makes a difference when you have a really good platform that you are using. So I'm gonna explain to you how the sender works. So this is the first option, obviously. So we have all these email accounts here, right? So you click on add sender and connect all your accounts using OAuth, and then you start warming up these accounts. For sending emails, we are only sending right now 10 emails per account per day. We will be soon increasing it to 15-20 emails per inbox. So for warm ups, we are always sending like 40-45 emails per inbox, obviously slowly ramped up. It will sometimes test your accounts with huge volume and see what spam rates you have, and if you have no spam rates, then the account is good to go. You don't really need to worry about anything. And if we have some accounts that don't have 100% reputation yet, what we would do is we will not be sending any emails from that account for a while, for like let's say 1 or 2 weeks, and test that out after that. And if it still doesn't perform, we will remove it, right? So this was about sender. You can see analytics of all your senders. You have the options for domains as well. So now let's move on to the CRM. You have all the lists. You can filter your list according to the campaigns they are in. You can create custom tags for your leads for about someone who you want to reach out later. You can filter your list. It's up to you how you want to segment these lists better here, and then port it or maybe create a new campaign based on the insights you have. Right now we have the Unibox here. I'm just showing you out of office replies. I cannot show you the interested ones. One more good thing about ManyReach is that their reply tracking is really great. With Smart Lead, we are not getting positive replies for even 2-3 days, but with ManyReach, we're almost instantly getting those replies in the inboxes, because when you are doing cold emails, the speed that which you reply your leads with really matters, right? So you manage all your replies here, book the calls. So let's move on to how to set up a campaign. So when you want to set up a campaign, you can just simply click on create a campaign, name your campaign. Next step is obviously upload your prospect list. I will just randomly select a list here. So let's say this is the list that I have for a client, obviously. So I'm gonna just map out the roles that we have. So it's first name, then you map out the company name, domain, website. And then if you have something that is personalization, then you can use custom 1, 2, 3, 4, how many ever custom filters that you want to create, add in the email script. Then next step is setting up the step. If you want to A/B test, the method is really different here, right? You cannot just create a separate part of email here. So let's say if I want to use this subject line, right, and I want to test another subject line, then what I can do is use spin and click A/B test and copy the first subject line that I have and you paste it here. So let's say this is the second subject line. So this is the A/B test that has been created here. Anything that you have to A/B test, let's say you have to test some lines inside the email, then you can just use this element. So this is how the A/B test works in here. If you want to use spin text, this is how you do it. If you want to add some personalizing elements, then you can use these. Let's say this is the email I want to send. This is how it would look like. Let's say if I want to show you the spin text here, I would just simply add in this manner like we usually do in Instantly and Smart Lead. Then it will simply give you this, and it in analytics as well, it will create different version. So this is the first email, then you create a follow-up, and it's up to you how many follow-ups you want to create. We usually do one follow-up after every 3 days, and we obviously reply that in the same thread. Then I'm gonna add something like this, and when I'm done setting up all these emails, adding anything or everything about, let's say I want to add links, images, it's up to you however you want to do it. Then we will move on to the settings of the campaign, which is major part to solve as well. You can create a folder for your campaigns based on the industries you are working with. Then you have the senders option, where you select all the email accounts you're going to use for yourself or your client. Then you have to select how many emails you want this to send a day per campaign or per sender. I have selected it to like 10 emails a day per sender. So if I'm selecting 70 email accounts, it's not gonna send more than 700 emails. Then sending schedule, obviously you don't want to send on Saturday, Sunday, or it's up to you which time zone you select from here. And all of these will be saved automatically. You don't need to press save, which is also a great feature, right? I don't want to track opens, I don't want to track click. Then for delivery optimization, I'm gonna send them in text only. Then advanced options, if you are setting up Google and Outlook inboxes both, then you should enable ESP matching. It will help you emails to Google inboxes from your Google inboxes and vice versa. Then limit ESP providers. If you want the emails to be sent out to only Google, then you select this. This is for the campaigns. Let's say you got a list of 50,000 leads and you're just randomly blasting emails. You have only Gmail accounts. In that case, I would recommend only send to Google as only. So daily sending limits. This is also a very crucial part of the campaign. So you don't want to send more than 10 new journeys, or even 7 to 8, I would say. Other 2-3 emails can be from this account follow-ups only. I would always say prioritize new leads, because the most replies you're gonna get is on the first email, right? And the minimum delay between emails, I would say keep it to 30 seconds, because you don't want all of the emails to be sent out in a minute, like all the 70 emails from 70 accounts. So with this, if you, let's say, select 300 seconds, then it's gonna send only 11 emails per hour. You don't want to do that. And you can obviously auto increase sends per day. Let's say you start with 5 emails per day, then you tell it to increase by 10% every day and maximum 20%. So let's say if you start with 5 emails per day and it increases by 10% emails per day, then it will start sending like 6 emails after 2 days, then 7 emails. It will gradually increase your limit, and you don't want it to go more than 15 emails per account. And that's why you set this limit to 15 emails per account. there are some additional grade setting as well. So if you haven't checked your list thoroughly after personalizing, you can enable this to make sure that no emails are being sent out to the leads that don't have any placeholders. You can stop sending to coworkers on reply, which is great if you're reaching out to multiple roles inside a company. Insert unsubscribe link in header is also a great option to be compliant with GDPR. Then all these options are up to you of what you want to do. And after you have set up everything here, just start the campaigns and wait for it to do its magic, and you will start getting replies. And when you are managing multiple clients, giving them access to all these settings and campaigns is really amazing. That will make your agency stand out, because it's not costing you anything to do that, right? So why wouldn't you do it? And if you're only selling positive replies, that becomes very easier as well. Now there you have it. I would say ManyReach have really solved the issue for a lot of people in terms of pricing and accessibility. If you're someone who's working with a lot of clients, managing a lot of email accounts, this makes segmentation really easier. This makes analytics very easier, right? And now I'm going to be attaching a sign up link in the description for this platform. You can use that to sign up for this if you want to and try this out for yourself. If you are looking out for a new platform, I would highly recommend you this. And if I haven't myself gotten results, I wouldn't have told you about this ever. Now, even if you don't sign up, I have 3 lists of leads that you can leverage to get clients for yourself. First is a list of 1000 AI company founders. Second will be the list of founders and CEO of funded e-commerce companies using Shopify Plus. So if you are selling email marketing, you know, performance marketing or anything, this can really help you. Third is if you are doing anything related to marketing, I have a list of founders and CEO who are looking to hire a marketing team in US. You can use that to reach out to them, because obviously they have the money to spend. So I'm gonna be attaching those 3 lists in the description only. If you have any questions related to this ever, feel free to ping me on LinkedIn or Instagram. Thank you for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.